Since its official launch in October 2015, Interpol's EU ASEAN Migration and Border Management Program has successfully trained over 641 frontline border officials from all 10 ASEAN member states.
This is really a landmark project that we have with Interpol. This collaboration has generated a lot of progress, I believe, in ASEAN.
The three-year program, funded by the European Union, is designed to support ASEAN with the implementation of its master plan on ASEAN connectivity by providing law enforcement officials with tangible policing capabilities to better manage the movement of peoples throughout the region. The program has also overseen the extension of Interpol's I-24/7 secure communication system to 26 of the main transit hubs in ASEAN.
And now when you look at the connectivity plan of ASEAN that they are developing, notably through this project, it's very interesting because it touches upon exactly what we are doing in the EU, the four freedoms: freedom of movement of people, of capital, of services, and of goods.
Throughout 2017, a series of capacity building and training activities were carried out in Myanmar, Indonesia, and Singapore. The aim of the training is to increase the skills and knowledge of law enforcement agencies dealing with border management in the ASEAN community.
It has built a very good platform for all those concerns to come together. We have everybody that could give good input into the agenda that we have at hand. We have those from security background, we have the scholars, we have those well-versed in economics of ASEAN. So this is all very comprehensive, and this, I'm sure, is going to help us to move forward.
This course is very beneficial in raising or in developing the skill of policing capabilities of each member countries. We learn a lot about the Interpol method in fighting and preventing crime using modern tools and equipments.
In May, the program conducted Operation Red Lotus, involving Indonesia, Myanmar, Cambodia, and the Philippines. Undertaken at international airports in Bali, Manila, Phnom Penh, and Yangon, Operation Red Lotus seeks to build closer collaboration between immigration and police agencies by exploiting Interpol's global policing capabilities to carry out enhanced passenger screening.
The operation is focusing on the land border, specifically the airports, to make sure that we're interdicting foreign fighters, any of the individuals that may be involved in other criminal activity in the area.
18.4 million passenger checks were carried out during the operation, resulting in more than 200 potential threats following hits against Interpol's stolen and lost travel documents database. These resulted in the arrest in Indonesia of three internationally wanted persons targeted by Interpol red notices, with the subject of an Interpol international diffusion alert also arrested in Thailand.
Part of the training, and then which leads to the operations, instills an institutional standard. As we see here today, we have several officers that are getting trained in both the practical use of the devices, but also the ability to use them in the field in real time. And that's one of the goals of this, is to make sure that people are working seamlessly across all of the region.
In November, the program team was deployed to assist law enforcement agencies in the Philippines for the 2017 ASEAN Summit. 24 million searches were carried out, resulting in 195 potential threats identified following hits against Interpol databases. Further investigative leads were also generated in a number of cases, involving seven arrested internationally wanted persons targeted by red notices in connection with rape, theft, drug charges, and fraud.